Previously on Project Zomboid. As you can see, everything is set up, or getting set up here at the new base down at the farm outside of Muldra. So, we're going to need more water, because the water obviously has been shut off for a while now. So I think what we're going to do right now is make ourselves some rain collectors. Okay, that's looking good. Perfect. It is almost 3 o'clock, so we got some time to head into town and do a little bit of looting. So we're very close to getting maxed out on carpentry. We can start making some cool stuff like that ox-drawn wagon. Small plastic. Oh god. Oh god. Get out of here. Where's the... Get out of here. There's a lot of them, guys. Okay. Ditch that. Screw that. I didn't realize there was a block party going on. Jesus Christ. Oh my god. What the hell? Ah! Run! Get out of here, JT. Hello everyone, my name is Nomis, and welcome back to another episode of Project Zomboid. We are picking up here a couple days after where we last left off, I guess. It's been a few days in game. What I have done in the meantime is chop down a bunch of trees and sawn up a bunch of planks. So we have a lot of lumber to work with here, including our 4 pallets of lumber down here. As you can see, I started going around all this way. I think we'll probably want maybe like 10 or 15 feet beyond our fence, clear of tree line, just so we can see zombies coming up on us if they do come out of the tree line. Anyway, spent a lot of time doing that. You can see down at the bottom right here, we are just about to cross over 3.5 months. So we've been at the farm for about a week, or just over a week now. And with all the, cutting down all those trees, I was able to level up our carpentry to level 9. And get about a third of the way to level 10. So we should have level 10 carpentry for next episode. Now, with all of this all these planks and pallets of lumber that we have, I think we're going to just start building walls using this instead of doing log walls, just because log walls take so long. I don't have nearly enough rip sheets to do a significant wall, so I think that's what we're going to start off the episode with, is we're going to unpack one of these pallets. Go in here, we'll just drop off the pallet and the thick rope. Start unpacking these lumber stacks, maybe just one at a time. There we go. And we'll just start building a wall. First, I want to just build a wall enclosing this area, just so we can work. This will be like our little work yard for now, just so we can work in peace and quiet. Don't have to worry about zombies sneaking up on us. So let's find where our hammer is. There it is. Unpack that. Make sure we have enough nails on us. We might not have any. We got 18. I'll probably want some more. So let's go run to the shed here. Grab another box of nails. And once we do get up to level 10 carpentry, we can just replace those walls and put up level 10 walls, and we can plaster them. Alright, so we'll take those loose nails. And 20 boxes, awesome. So let's just open up one of these boxes of nails. That should be more than enough to last us for what we need to do today. And I think we'll just go straight off of this corner for now. So we'll go wooden wall. And I did have a suggestion to do a complete perimeter wall, kind of around the whole farm area there, like the garden area, down around the coop, and then all the way around the barn as well. So we'll try and start working towards that. We might do it in sections, I don't know. But for now, I think we'll just enclose this area across here, and then across this way, and then probably just across like that. So I'm going to do that right now, and I'll edit back once that is complete. Alright, Just putting the last wall on here. Things are looking good, and we're actually about halfway now to level 10 carpentry, so maybe we'll get it done today. We are quite hungry. Let's chow down on a MRE here. We'll probably have to eat this whole thing. Got quite hungry building those walls. So this is what I've got here. I put a little door on the front there so we could get in. But yeah, I think this will work. This will work nicely. It gives us a little bit of room to build a few more things in here as well. Now let's go see if we have... I don't think we have a doorknob, but we can see if we have a doorknob and hinges. We could break down a couple doors inside, if need be, to put a door on there. I don't see anything in here now. No doorknob, no door hinges. Let's see if we can break down one of the doors inside and get a couple of hinges and a doorknob, and then we'll put a door on that work area. Okay, so we got one doorknob and a hinge off of this door. Yeah, let's break this one down. Another doorknob, looking for a hinge though. Alright, down with... Actually, let's do the bathroom door. Yeah. There we go, there's a hinge. Perfect. We'll just take these planks as well. Might as well. Couple planks there. And one plank there. Oh, can't quite fit it. Throw it in the pack, dog. Alright, let's throw this door on. And one wooden door. Throw that on there. Complete this area. Perfect. Okay. Let's get rid of this little tree here. It's going to slow us down every once in a while. Get rid of that. Sop those logs. We'll take the XP. Oh. There we go. Alright, what do we have for XP now? Yeah, we're still sitting around half. Okay, so the other thing I wanted to do today was make a junkyard. I don't think that's enough. How many planks do we need? I know we need some planks. Lumber stack. Junkyard. Make small junkyard. Here we go. Keep spade, keep hammer. Three nails and three planks. Because we are starting to collect some trash. Some trash bags. So we could start scavenging through these junkyards. And maybe if we upgrade to a large one, we could find some good stuff. First, we'll build this one. There we go. And I guess we might as well put it in here. Until we have another area for it. So we'll just put it back in this corner. Let's see, where is our junkyard? Small, empty junkyard. It's pretty big when you place it down. So you want to make sure you get it placed where you want it. That looks good. Okay. So to fill up a junkyard, we're going to need a couple small garbage bags. I think we just have one right now. We've got a visitor. Got a visitor, though. Hold on, sir. I gotta drop some stuff off first. And I'll be with you momentarily. What's weighing us down? These planks. Alright, hold on. Oh, Mr. Zombies. Where is our knife? There we go. Get that equipped. Could always use more sheet ropes to make more rope from their clothing, so I'm gonna do that. Never have too many ropes, especially with all those planks that need to be bundled up back there. So we'll grab these. Very good. And let's see, where are they? Make one rope out of that. Alright. Just dump that on the floor. Alright, let's go back to our junkyard. I'll close that window. Yeah, we only have the one trash bag for right now, so I'll take that over. We're going to need two, I believe, to fill it up. We can check the crafting menu to make sure. Let's just dump this over here. Open up our crafting menu. Where would it be? Under engineer, maybe. Junk. Make small junkyard. Refill small junkyard. So we're gonna need two small bags of trash to fill up the small junkyard. And then we could search through the junk here from the small full junkyard. Or we could wait and upgrade it. Actually, we could probably, oh no, we don't have the sheet metal, but we could upgrade it to a medium junkyard. And then, can we upgrade that again to a large junkyard? I don't see an option there. To upgrade to a large junkyard. But we can upgrade to a medium one. So we have these other, well, not the small, full junkyard yet, but we'll have to keep an eye out for sheet metal. Unless we can make sheet metal. Let's go over to our blacksmithing tab. Look up sheet metal. No. Not that I can see. All right. Well, what else should we do today, guys? We should eat. Let's eat that. I'd really like to get up to level 10 carpentry. We're so close. So close indeed. Let's think here. What can we use for carpentry? We could make a bunch of sturdy sticks out of planks. We could make a bunch of notched planks. So we could use those with our smelter and kiln instead of our lighter. So let's see if we have a screwdriver here. We don't have a screwdriver. There's probably one back in the warehouse, though. Here, let's make some sturdy. Make a bunch of sturdy sticks. Let's see how much that upgrades our carpentry by. So we're at 4551 right now. 4572. Sure, let's just make a bunch of sturdy sticks. Go. Make sturdy stick. We could make some shingles in anticipation of our future beehives. Okay. Some more loose planks over here. What else can we make? We can make a bat. Homemade club. We've never made a stake before. Let's make a stake. Maybe we can start using the stake as a weapon. Okay, make that. We are now up to almost 4700 XP. Let's make a few more things. Might as well make a splint. That's always good to have. Okay, made a splint. Let's make. Sure, let's make a bat. Takes three planks. Crude bat, homemade bat. Wonder what's better. I think one's Hydrocraft and one's base game. I've never made one before. You can make a campfire kit too. We actually need one of those. I don't think that takes carpentry skill, but we do need one. Okay. And let's see. Let's make some more shingles. All right. Up to 4800. So that added another couple hundred XP. Let's put all these things that we just made into our carpentry bench. Just to store them. We'll keep the splint on us, I think. We can put all these sturdy sticks in there, all the shingles. Good. Put the saw back in our bag. And I think we'll head out to the warehouse now to see if we can't find a screwdriver. Hey, sir. Take your clothes. And I got one more sheet over here. We can make one more rope. All right, make rope. There we go. So we'll go see if we can find a screwdriver, and then I think we'll just make a ton of notched planks, and we'll use that as fuel for our kiln and smelter for a little bit. So I'll cut back once we've arrived back at the warehouse. Here we are. Still looks... Oh, no. A little bit of a group down there, but it's quiet on this end. We know this back door is open. Windows are still intact. Means no one's broken in unless they've broken on the front. Let's see here. Yeah, those windows are still intact. Okay, very good. All right, let's pick up some more supplies here. We want a screwdriver most of all, but we'll take a bunch of these other things. Since we're down here. Pliers, some thread, bungee cord. Take all that. I don't think we need the pliers right now. Newspaper. Yeah, we'll take that shotgun now. Crowbar, I guess we could smelt that down to get iron. Take the tent peg. So we'll have to make another mine at some point. If we want to make our well. Tent pegs. And we'll be coming back here yet again to break all of these crates down. Make sure we grab everything from here. Pretty sure we have a needle, but let's take one just in case. Take some batteries. So we could set up a few lamps as well today if we want to. Wire, PVC pipe, sandbag and nails, good, take all that stuff. There's bound to be a screwdriver in here somewhere. We do have a few pallets of materials as well that we've left behind here. Make sure we have a funnel. More lighters and tent pegs. Pinch clamp, interesting. We could come back for a load of charcoal as well. Seems to be a few things of charcoal around here. Let's just dump them out on the ground so we can easily tell where they are. Dump that one out. Trowel, I'm pretty sure we have one. Another spade. Box of nails. Okay, take both of those. I'm not going to bother with the sandbag. Take that power cord. Jackknife, come on, screwdriver, there's got to be one in here. Take the copper pipe. Nail gun ammo we'll take. Not seeing it. You would have thought there'd be one in here with all these crates. If we don't find one easily, I might take out the sledgehammer and we'll just start breaking boxes now. So I kind of really want it. Come on, give me those nails. Go. It's starting to get dark out too. So we'll probably sleep here the night. Tent pegs. Some plaster powder. Okay. Let's put that on the ground. We'll need that very soon. More lighters. Lots of tent pegs. More nails. More charcoal. About half full on our bag now. I think we'll need a paintbrush once we do start plastering. So we'll take that with us. Aluminum bat would come in handy. Make sure we have enough wooden crates for future builds. Some barbed wire. Don't need that second sledgehammer, really. Flashlight, sure. Hedge cutters, yep. But we need a screwdriver to dismantle those. Take a slingshot. Saw, another mason trowel. Come on, nothing. Another pulley, okay. Well, we'll check upstairs. Might be out of luck, though. Nail gun nails. We might be out of luck. It doesn't look like we're going to have a screwdriver. A pallet of lumber here. Take that back with us. Okay. There's no boxes upstairs anyway. Alright, let's sleep here the night. In the morning, I think I'm going to bring out the sledgehammer right now. Oh, I have a screwdriver. Jeez. How long were you guys yelling at this screen? Okay, well, we're going to sleep here regardless. Of course I have a screwdriver. Alright. Well, we got a bunch of good loot anyway. We're pretty much full of those, so we'll just sleep here. I might bring one of the pallets back with us of stones, maybe. We don't necessarily need them, but since we have the mine, let's see, I know it's on the ground here. Or should we bring the bricks back? I'm not sure what else we can make with bricks, to be honest. I think we're good. Let's just head back. Okay, so I'll cut back once we are back at the farm. And we'll do a little bit more carpentry work. Let's see if we can get this leveled up to level 10 today. Okay. So, let's take this pallet of lumber that we picked up today. Actually, we don't need to unpack it. We've got some stacks here. Let's just put this on the ground. Let's use these stacks up first. Okay, so we're going to make a notched wooden plank, right? And how do we do that again? I thought we just needed our screwdriver. Do we need to unpack it? We might need to unpack it. Let's unpack it. Wooden toolbox, and a stake. Where's notched? What am I missing here, guys? Thought that's all we needed. Let's go over to carpentry. Let's see. What's it called? Drill a plank? Is it plank? Soak plank in vegetable oil? What the? No. What is it even called, guys? Is it like called drill a plank? Make a drill plank. I think this is. Is this it? I can't even remember. Let's see. Notch wooden plank. Yeah. Okay. So let's drill a bunch of planks. I don't even know if that uses up carpentry experience. 48, 22, 48, 44. Yeah, it does. Okay. We'll make a bunch of these. We'll probably just unpack these stacks of lumber here. Get a bunch of notched wooden planks ready for our smelter. And where is it here? Drill, drill, drill. Drill plank, there we go. Do all those. Let's take these over to this area. Just drop them on the ground. Good. Let's do one more stack. Where is it? Let me pick it up. Let me pick it up. There we go. Unpack this one. Drill all those. Good. Alright, so it's not a lot, but it'll last us a while, save us from using our lighter. Okay, so up to 5570 XP. So we got 4500 to go. What else can we do, guys? Should we put a wooden floor in here? No, I don't think so. What else to do? What else to do? That could give us carpentry. I could just start chopping down more trees and sawing them up. That's probably the easiest thing. Let's go do that. Since there aren't any zombies right now, take advantage and start chopping trees. Okay, guys, so I'm going to edit through this, or fast forward at least. And we'll come back once I have a ton of logs to saw up. Okay, that's a lot of logs. Let's see what we can get as far as carpentry experience sawing these up. No zombie noises or zombies coming out of the woods. So if there's any nearby, you'd expect them to have heard all that chopping. Let's just go ahead and saw up a bunch of logs here. The old carpentry grind to level 10. I can't remember the last time we actually got to level 10 carpentry. I don't think we did last season, did we? We were probably pretty close. Oh no, we did, because we were plastering walls at the very end on that last day. That's right. Alright, we're very close now, guys. Probably won't even need to saw up all these logs. Exciting gameplay! But it is a momentous milestone, so I want to make sure you guys get to see us get to level 10. I hope you have enough logs. We might be a couple short, actually. Let's see. Oh, we're so close. 85, 66. Oh yeah, we've got this. We got this, guys. Level 10, here we come. Couple more, you think? I think we got this. So close now. Just a few more. Oh, where are we at? 89.40. We'll have just enough. Boom. Alright guys, drumroll. Level 10 carpentry. We did it. That was actually a perfect amount of logs. I don't know, there's one more back here. Okay, I'm gonna get to bed here. We'll come back in the morning. I gotta eat because we are very hungry. Don't want to starve to death during the night. And we'll start building some cool level 10 carpentry stuff, guys. Next morning has arrived. I've just finished packing up a couple pallets, or a few pallets of lumber. Got a few visitors here. Take care of them. I'm bleeding in our garden area. You bastards. I should have drawn them out. Oh well. We won't be planting crops until spring. It is December 2nd, so... too cold for crops, I think. And a couple more zombies apparently have wandered in. There was a meta-noise gunshot during the night, so... or early in the morning, I should say. So it has drawn a few towards us. We'll just clean these guys up. And we're going to take a look at our carpentry tab and see what cool things we can build now with level 10 carpentry, because there are a lot of them in the Hydrocraft mod, I think. I've never actually looked because I hardly ever get to level 10 carpentry. But it'll be good enough time as any to do it now. Okay, let's drop those pallets just for now. It's already dusk. Slept quite a bit. Okay, so carpentry. We could start making the ingredients of our cart, our wagon. Let's look up those, maybe. What we're going to need for our wagon. So we need 3 lumber stacks, so 1 pallet, essentially. 2 logs, 4 wagon wheels. Oh, well, this isn't too hard. We can make this right now. Each wagon wheel, we're going to need 2 wooden rings, so that's 8 wooden rings in all. 24 sturdy sticks. Well, we definitely have the sturdy sticks. So let's, and 12 units of glue. Okay. Let's go do that. Let's go make that. What was it again? The sturdy sticks and the rings, right. Okay, do we have any wooden blocks? Not sure if we do in here. No, we don't. We have the sticks. Or most of them. We're gonna need some logs, though. Did I leave any logs? There's a couple logs here. Perfect. Alright, let's take these. Head back over here. Let's pick up this stack. Around. Head over to our carpenter's bench. Oh, it's quite dark. Here, let's do this. Let's unpack this. Build ourselves a chair in here. Hammer, hammer, hammer. I'm just gonna sleep inside the shed tonight. Furniture, because I'm too lazy to go inside. Let's do it right in the corner. Is that the corner? Is that outside? Is that inside? I can't even tell. I think that's the corner. Nope, that's outside apparently. How about right there? Okay, we're getting thirsty and hungry as well, so I'll fill ourselves up with some MRE, of course, and we'll come back in the morning and we'll start making these wagon wheels. There we go, a bit brighter now. So let's make some wood blocks. We'll just do one for now. We'll drop that log on the ground. Let's make some wooden rings. Craft wooden ring. We might as well make them all. So we're gonna use all of them, or mostly all of them. Okay, very good. Let's make one more thing of sturdy sticks to make sure we have enough. All right, make. Let's see here, coffin, wash tub, honeycomb frame. What are we missing for our wagon wheels? The wood glue. Okay. Let's grab some wood glue from our shelf. Wood glue. There we go. Not sure how many it's going to take. We'll take four with us, though. That should be more than enough. Okay, carpenter's bench. I want to be able to access the bench and the crate. There we go. Make wagon wheel. Go ahead and make one of those. Awesome. Can we make another one? What are we missing now? Wood glue. Don't we have enough here? Oh my god. That uses a lot of wood glue. Okay. Well, we need the wagon, so I guess we're taking the rest of this wood glue. Take all that. Good thing we have a lot. Okay, let's try again. Make wagon wheels, three more. One, two, three. So we have four wagon wheels now. Fantastic. We need three lumber stacks and two logs. So I need one more log. Let's go get one more log. We have our axe out still. No, we don't. Equip that. I think we'll end the episode off once we've made this wagon. There we go. So let's take both of those. Head back inside. We're getting really thirsty now. Let's try and finish this up. Okay, so we got the logs. Let's grab. Alright, so we're gonna need a pallet for the three stacks. Let's unpack that over here. Unpack that. Okay, let's try it. Make a. Oh, where is it? What are we missing? What does it say we don't have? The two logs. Okay. Let's just pick those up. There we go. Alright, ready to go now. Build a wagon. Two logs, three lumber stacks, 50 nails. Oh my god, that's a lot of nails. Four wagon wheels, The hammer and saw, we have our level 10 carpentry. Let's go ahead and make a wagon, guys. Oh my god, we got a wagon. It weighs 40. Okay, that's quite heavy. Let's throw that log down. We're gonna throw the wagon in our pack dog, because that makes... that's logical. Okay, there we go. I think we're just gonna take it outside so we can bask in its glory. If I can find it here, there we go. Pick that up. All we need now is to find some cow poop through foraging. Get some oxen. Look at that. That's pretty cool. So it's got a capacity of 400, weight reduction of 50. We'll be able to fit a lot of stuff in there, guys. Alright, let's pop it open our menu again. We might as well see if we can throw a bonnet on here. 4 tarps, 10 more sturdy sticks, okay. And some more nails. 4 tarps. We should have the tarps, shouldn't we? Let's see. Tarps, tarps, tarps. Where are our tarps? Hopefully I brought them down with us. Yes, we have 6. Okay, so let's pick up 4. There we go. Grab some more nails. Good. And some more sturdy sticks. How many do we need? 10? I think it's at 10. 10 sturdy sticks, okay. And 10, there we go. Let's put a bonnet on this bad boy. Protect it from the rain. Add a bonnet to the wagon. Ooh, this is exciting, guys. So once we have the ox, we can, well, I guess we could just take it ourselves. We could equip it with both hands. I guess that's an option. Cool. Well, I think that'll do it for today, guys. What I might do in between episodes is do some foraging, see if we can't scrounge up some cow poop and search for a oxen, although I guess we're going to need a herding dog first. I guess we'll have to go back to that warehouse, break all the crates, see if there's a dog whistle in there somewhere. But that'll do it for today. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, feel free to hit that like button. Leave me a comment below. What do you think of our new wagon with bonnet? I think it looks pretty cool. The Hydrocraft team did a pretty good job, and it's pretty cool. We are at level 10 carpentry now. We'll be able to take a look at a lot of different builds. So let me know what you guys want us to build next. But until next time, I'll talk to you all later.